So we'll see, because two things will happen. Either it's going to explode and come out of the panel. I got power off at this point. We're going to go back here and check our capacitor bank. I am set to DC volts. So we're down to 13 volts already. It's been about 10 minutes since I shut it down. And you can see we're steadily dropping. So probably needs another 5 minutes or so, and it'll be good. Once that bank is finally dead, I'll start pulling everything off. Got the new IGBT in, got new snubbers in, everything looks good, I'm pretty happy with it. We were locking out on a great gate driver fault. Usually when we run into this, it's typically an IGBT issue. Did a meg test on the compressor windings, compressor meg good, the capacitor bank and everything looked good. Circuit 2 was not having any issues at all out of its IGBT. Apparently they had been having this lockout for some time. If it trips, I think it's 3 times in 24 hours or twice in 24 hours, something like that. It locks out at that point, but it will give it 1 or 2 faults before an actual lockout condition. I felt comfortable. We recommended a gate driver on system 1. I'm going to reset the lockout. Then I'm going to move system 1 to the on position. And I'm going to go to system 2 and move it to the off position so that we can get 1 online. Back to status. And then we'll flip it to on. We've already got flow. Automation is calling. We're doing a pre-charge. So we'll see, because two things will happen. Either it's going to explode and come out of the panel, or it's going to turn on and run perfect. When you're doing that plug, make sure you take a thermostat screwdriver and push those pins down in there so you get really good seat. Be very critical that you put the thermal paste on really well and you get that whole bottom side covered, and that you're tightening down the mounting bolts evenly. I have done a video already on doing a full change out on this. I did it a couple of months ago, I think. So I've got video out there. If you want to check it out, you can go see the total procedure start to finish. If you're going to do a meg check on this, on a drive like this, make sure you pull the motor terminal leads off and meg it, you know, from there. You can't leave it hooked up. You'll cause a backfeed through the IGBT, which is going to tear some stuff up. Also, make sure you do your snubbers. We got a bunch of machines about this age, and all of them have just started having these IGBT issues over time. And it's very, very normal for them. So if you are working a property, it's say 08 to 012 or anywhere in that ballpark, and you haven't had to do IGBTs on it, you really want to start putting in your budget possibility of needing to do them. I also have a video I did a couple of years back on changing the entire IGBT assembly. They call it a power assembly or a pole assembly, because the capacitor bank had split and broken, and one of the SCRs had completely shorted to ground and was blowing the fuses, which the fuses on these are those little white squares back there with a red dot. When that red dot pokes out, that fuse is blown. It's not resettable. You have to replace it. That red dot's just an indicator. The amps look really good. The IGBT inverter plate temperature looks really good. Very happy with our current condition. It is how we're running. MTT, take care of your family. Take care of your spouse. Enjoy this video. I'll see y'all in the next one.